author was that I read a lot as a child, and my mom raised me on books and stories and all that stuff, so even at a young age, I loved creating stories. And when I became a younger teenager, I wrote a lot on role-playing forums, and eventually that just led me to write an actual novel. What I hope to gain out of being an author is just people enjoying my writing. That was always the biggest thing to me, was I worried that people wouldn't like it, or, you know, I was always super ecstatic when they did like it, when someone fell in love with my characters. It was kind of like an extra boost, like they fell in love with a part of me, and that sounds super narcissistic, but at the same time, it was mainly that I could bring joy to their lives, as opposed to actually anything personal. Roadblocks. I'm extremely judgmental of my writing. Like, I will write something one day, completely adore it, and then the next day I read over it and I hate it. So a lot of the times I had to force myself to step away from the book in order to have a better outlook on it, so it wasn't just a bunch of gibberish, if that makes any sense.
Gag reel.
Aside from being an author, I think my heart is in being a librarian, because I've always wanted to work with books and help other people find books and help them, you know, just book-related stuff, really. I'm psycho for books. I currently volunteer at my local library as I go through high school and finish that up. And then I'll be getting my degree in library science, which will let me be an actual hardcore librarian. That's pretty much my future goal.
Do you think you can see it? Well, until you get the goal, go ahead and scream it, just say.
My inspiration for being an author, I would have to say, is mainly my friends, just the quirky people that I meet and am around day to day. Gives me inspiration not only for stories, but the characters and ideas that build off of that. It's hard to put a finger on exactly when I first started writing. I've been making scripts and trying to make movies and things like that since as early as kindergarten, and casting friends in those. So, as long as I can really remember, I've been writing in one form or fashion. If I were going to have any job other than being an author, other than writing, it would definitely be acting. Acting is the only thing that I have had a true passion for. Even though I've written for as long as I can remember, I've had a true passion for acting since, I mean, before I even have memories. I know my parents have told me about different theatrical things I've done. And it's just a passion that's stuck with me throughout the years, and I've always wanted to have some place in film, specifically acting. There are several writers that I admire a lot, not only as writers, but as people. But I would have to say currently, the writer that I look up to the most would have to be J.K. Rowling. I think she's not only a great fictional writer and a very entertaining read, but I think that she also puts a lot of great things about humanity and morality and just the magic and wonder that captures us all as children and that we so often forget about into her works. Roadblocks in getting my book published. Some roadblocks in getting my book published. There actually haven't been too many. The hardest part of it was definitely writing the book and staying focused on it. Because not long after I finished, King James Publishing came along and everything kind of just took off from there. So it's been surprisingly smooth sailing, I'd say, with this. The hardest part in all, it's just been really the writing.
All I need is the air I breathe.
you're fading. Best piece of advice for another author would be to dedicate yourself to the cause. I've heard a multitude of amazing ideas from a lot of talented artists who don't have the dedication to finish the project, and thus there's no editing can't help them, cover design can't help them, marketing can do nothing for them. If you can't dedicate yourself to finishing the product, there's no product. You're not an author. You're just a short story writer. Working with the King James Publishing Group, I feel, has helped me as an author really achieve my goals, and I feel like they can help other people achieve their goals. I feel like they're the most creative, dedicated, honest people in the publishing industry, and they're the only people that I've seen that actually care if anything good happens for you. If you do well and they don't, they're still happy, and I don't know any other publishing company that's willing to go that far. The three best characteristics of an author: one is creativity, because if you can't think of an idea that someone else hasn't already put down in a format and published, then you can't write anything. You'll spend your entire career in legal battles, never making any money and constantly paying other people for things they've already made. The second most important ability for an author to have is the ability to endure. If you can't see your project through to the end, if you can't take your amazing idea and write it all the way through, you can never have a book. If you can't have a book, you're not an author. And I think a lot of people underestimate the powerful feeling that having the published work that you've sat through for these first years, months, at least, and having it in your hand is a very euphoric experience. To us, it's like winning the Super Bowl. The third most important ability for an author to have is the ability to be open, to be willing to work with the other departments, to be willing to work with other people, and the ability to just be open to change. A lot of times, you'll have an amazing idea, but maybe when you put it down on paper, something in the process bogged down. You have to be willing to let the editing department do its job. You know, sometimes the cover ideas that the cover department comes through with, maybe you don't agree with, but maybe that's what's best for your book. So you have to be open to letting these changes happen while maintaining your own idea and maintain that original vision, but letting other people help you help the vision. Liking ketchup, that's a major, important part of the publishing industry. You don't like ketchup, I won't work with you. I have my standards. Maybe not with people, but with ketchup.
What inspired me to make the King James Publishing Group is dealing with publishers out there as an author. Many publishing companies with the degrees and the people throughout the country, they all have different limitations on what they want and what they do not want. And me being an author, I feel like, and I know that I shouldn't be limited because of what other people think, to come out with work, especially artistic work, as the industry that I'm in, that's basically book publishing, or coming out with a book, or being an author or a writer, of one that construct manuscripts through writing. When you get involved with the industry itself, you realize that you would be ignored, you would be turned around, and sometimes it's like you don't even exist. The King James Publishing Group is totally opposite than all those things that you would see in the publishing industry. We are authors as well as business people in the publishing industry that really want to help you. They both got their difficulties. Being an author, for me as an author, is enjoyable. Writing, putting, basically, being an author, because every author have their own way of putting their book or what they want to write, they should be anyway. Because being an author, usually dealing with your ideas and your thoughts, your imagination, and plus how you look at life itself. So for me, that's enjoyable. But at the same time, it's hard work. The publishing business is enjoyable also, because I enjoy publishing, but it's more hard work than enjoyable. If you're an artist, whatever comes your way, as an artist, we are there to help you. And that's why the company been created, is to help authors, not limit them, not to turn you around because they feel like this author is could sell and you can't sell. No, we want to make your dreams come true. We want your dreams to come true. An author, an innovator, someone that never gives up.
Do you know where you're